into silence, then another has by his words. Phillips Brooks. That was what I thought was today's quote of the day from my daily quote flip calendar thing, but then I'm realizing I accidentally flipped to June 17th instead of May 17th. So, preview. Hi guys, welcome to the Aztec MC server. I am Hayley the Tall Girl, and I'm so sorry for getting the date wrong on this calendar that absolutely nobody but myself can see. Yeah. So currently in the time lapse, you'll see me working on a moon base to go along with this cottagecore mushroom village fairy fantasy type vibe that I have going on with this little area that I'm building in. I have a lot of different projects going on right now, which is exciting, but then it's a little bit overwhelming and there's a lot of different like moving parts because I'll build some things in one area, take a break and go build another place in another area, and obviously take my regular breaks from playing my get burnt out and tired from it. But I do say that I have spent a lot of time yesterday working on this specific area, which is fun because I feel like I've been working on the desert base for a while, and the YouTube builder that I'm like quote unquote featuring today is Kelpie the Fox, who I feel like videos are becoming more and more popular, at least their recommendations are on my feed constantly. I really like the aesthetic style, the tutorials, very easy to follow, very vibey. And yeah, they all kind of right now, they all go with the same theme, so that's why I decided to do a bunch of the different builds together. They didn't take very long. I think maybe at most this moon house was 30 to 45 minutes, and I kept having to go and gather resources, specifically birch wood, because I forgot I had a whole bunch in my little log cabin over in the corner. But yeah, and then the other builds were like 15 minutes long, 20 long, 30. The last thing that I do today, the barn that you'll eventually see that I started out in front of, that was like an hour and a half, but just because playing in survival makes building go so much slower because you have to fight off the mobs, you have to deal with weather, you have to just constantly manage your inventory and run back and find exactly what your resources are needed. And especially when you're filming, like for the type of filming that I'm doing, it's hard to go to travel large chunks because it's just not really great for the replay mod. It just sometimes it's completely blank and you can't see anything but void, so that's fun. So when I'm filming with this case, I try really, really hard not to travel very far, which sometimes makes it harder because some of the items that I need are like all the way over, like a few chunks over, and it's like if I go get them, then like this whole clip might not render properly, which yeah, definitely happened to me last night within an hour and a half that I filmed. So I really hope I can go back and save that clip because I did a lot of work on that one. And if I lose the footage on that, that will be really, really sad. But yes, as of right now, all the clips for Kelpie the Fox builds going great. Really loved everything that we did. We have the moon house finished. I'm starting work on the fairy tree thing. Yeah, nice tree. I'll probably go in and put more foliage either Tuesday, Thursday, or Friday whenever I have time, which I might not actually have time on Tuesday because Tuesdays are my busy day, and then Thursdays I also have a math class, but Friday. I am realizing that summer is like basically here, and I'll have a lot more time to make videos. Like today and yesterday, I've had just a really nice time being able to play Minecraft and hang out and work on this, and several videos at the same time, and different research projects like the Aztec MC history project that I'm currently doing and doing interviews for. So if you are interested in being interviewed about your experience on the Aztec C server, either through voice chat or like message text, I am happy to conduct interviews of various different experiences. There's a lot of, like, one of the great things about Aztec is that it caters to so many different playing types, and there's so many different players who have made a huge impact on the server and to different people who've been a part of the community. So hearing from a variety of different voices and perspectives would only make the overall function of what I'm doing all the better, because it's more like, I realize it's kind of journalistic, but it's more anthropological in the sense that I want to understand and see where everybody is coming from and how they play the game of Minecraft individually. It all comes together to create this really interesting and pretty committed community. I don't remember the last time like Minecraft survival multiplayer has been popular like this, that I physically have felt. I feel like it must have been way back, I don't know, early days of Minecraft. I also feel like right now is pretty much the perfect time to start this project, because it's in this kind of, I don't want to say lull of the server gameplay, but it's at this point where the rich players are rich, the raiding players have raided, and the grieving players have griefed, and the building players are building, and all is going as status quo as possible. Things are still interesting if you still put the time and effort into it, and it's really still anybody's game, but it's all pretty established. The end, super rated. The Nether, I feel like you can't go anywhere in the Nether without seeing some sort of evidence of other players, which is understandable. But it's definitely that time in the server where it's been a long time since reset, and talking to the admins and other players, there's a bunch of other people who are just waiting for the map reset. So it's definitely a really interesting time to figure out who's, like, quote unquote, the king or queen, gender neutral, the royalty of the map right now. And who finishes off this particular map strong, and who will come out the next one swinging. I'm really excited for map reset and the first few hours, even though I feel like it will be super impossible to get on. It'll still be a vibe, but, you know. I'm very curious to see who comes back, who immediately sets themselves up as, you know, somebody to be afraid of, and what groups, you know, die and what groups are resurrected. Because as I go through this history project of the Aztec server, I am realizing there are a lot of different clans and organizations within the server, and I am very interested, because it feels like, especially this last few months within the pandemic, that side of the server has really taken off and created its life of its own. And hello, here's me kind of writing on it, talking about it, but also kind of giving clarity. So if there's anything that anybody ever wants me to talk about, that's like, something happens, one group raids another group's big mega base or something, or one person inside another group, let me know, because I'll talk about it, I'll interview. It's something that's pretty, you know, I am a person at asking questions. I'm good at asking questions. That's something I learned about myself within my years of being an adult person. I don't know, whatever you want to call me. I don't want to call myself an adult because I don't feel like an adult because, that's scary. But yeah, I'm good at asking questions. I'm good at like kind of figuring out the story to things. So if there's anything that ever happens on the server, let me know. I'll add it to my history project, whatever, which will one day be finished. But again, if you want to help me out, just let me know, DM me on Discord, in-game, comment on my YouTube, get back to you eventually. But I do most of the work during the week, so probably expect some time during the weekdays. But yeah, that's about it for this video, and yeah. Wow, that was a lot. I will have to say that was a lot, but I am proud of what we've done. I am excited. I am happy with all of this. I'm excited to continue, and I am now inspired. One thing I forgot to say during that very long time lapse where I talked a lot is that the thing about using YouTuber builds is that it gets you started on the creativity. If you're having one of those off days where you want to build something but you just don't know how to get started, and you have the resources and everything, you can just outsource your creativity to somebody who's given you a tutorial because like they wanted to, and then make it your own, because that's the way Minecraft is. Like, unless you're building block by block in a flat world, you can basically make it so it fits into your realm. And if you make a mistake, go with it. Like, I feel like every single build that I build off a tutorial on YouTube, I like get the frame like one larger than it's supposed to be originally in the tutorial, so it's always just super awkward. While I'm talking, I'll go back and put these on, but I think it's really nice to be able to just, you know, use the community to help inspire you, because that is Minecraft. Minecraft can be a very individual, isolated game, but there's so much content out there, and there's so much inspiration to be had by looking at like what people put out there absolutely for free. And I bet like it's a lot to see their like other people use their builds as inspiration. And yeah, I don't know. I just wanna make it known that building YouTube, it's cyclical. There's like the people that put the videos out, and then there's the people that just use the videos as inspiration and then take it like to whatever level that they feel like. I don't know, getting philosophical. But I'm gonna go ahead, say goodbye, say thank you so much for dealing, and say it might be like another week until we come back to this place. But we love Kelpie the Fox builds. I am addicted, but forget the C. Addicted.